Moses Thomas had been living a quiet life in Philadelphia since he fled Liberia in 2000. But the Liberian community there knew who he was and what he had done. They elected justice activists who worked with four victims to build a civil case against him. Now the judge has ruled in the victim's favor. He is directly liable for the wrongful acts during the massacre, Judge Patrice Tucker wrote. He intentionally directed an attack on a building dedicated to religion, personally directed an attack on civilians, and committed a crime against humanity of persecution. He oversaw the events and only declared an end to the shooting when he understood the occupants of the church to have been all killed. Judge Tucker found the victims lost close relatives and suffered serious prolonged physical and mental harms as a result of the massacre. Thomas returned to Liberia in 2019. Reached by whom, he angrily reacted to the news.
It's a stupid judgment. It's an abuse of justice. Abuse of justice and a stupid judgment. Judgment without evidence. What is the evidence? It's nonsense.
Mr. Thomas, the court said your lawyers failed to respond to the pleadings and the allegations against
you. I'm not in America, so that's what the court will say, but I say it's nonsense. I know that I was not part of a Lutheran church massacre. I did not go. Even the bishop, the Lutheran bull, everybody know who committed the act.
Thomas refused to name the person he says committed the act. He challenged Liberian authorities at the National Security Agency, NSA, police, and military to look into the affairs. A new U.S. judge will now decide how much he should pay the victims. If he has assets in the U.S., they will be seized. The victims can also try to enforce the judgment in Liberia. Thomas insists he is not paying a damn.
The U.S. court said that you should pay some money in terms of compensation to the victims.
To pay is nonsense, it's stupidity.
The four victims are keeping silent and their identities have been kept secret to protect them from retaliation. But the organizations that helped them to bring their suit hailed the court's ruling.
This is the first court decision to find conclusive evidence of government responsibility for the Lutheran Church massacre. And it's the first time there has been accountability for atrocities committed by the armed forces of Liberia during the First Civil War.
CJA and their Liberian partner, Global Justice and Research Project, are now challenging the Weah administration to prosecute Thomas in Liberia. Now that Thomas is back in Liberia, the Liberian government must investigate and prosecute him for this crime and any others. Until there is domestic accountability in Liberia, survivors and victims cannot live in peace, says Hassan Bedete, director of GJRP.
To prosecute Thomas, Liberian prosecutors would have to mount their own case, though they would have access to the Philadelphia case. Justice Minister Musadi did not respond to requests for comment, but given the Weah administration's unwillingness to establish a war crimes court for Liberia, it's unlikely they will mount any challenge against Thomas. Thomas says he's unafraid.
Let them go to the Liberian government and let them prosecute me for a Lutheran church. I say it's stupidity. I don't even want to talk about it. If they get any evidence, let them produce the evidence.
Survivors of the massacre say they are happy for the historic ruling that finally holds someone accountable for the massacre that devastated their lives. Her then 3-year-old son is now 32 and walks with crutches after his left leg was amputated from the wounds of 8 bullets. He says witnesses have been afraid since Thomas returned.
We are the victims. Every time we speak out to the media and this thing going around, maybe they might come after us. Who knows that? Because the more we talk, the more they get angry. They don't want to be brought to justice. They might attack us. We don't have security. Most people in government, they kill them, nothing come out of it, and one more for a little man that maybe we don't even have a delivery every week or day to eat.
For now, Thomas joins a growing list of combatants who are being forced to answer for their wartime actions. This report was produced by Power TV in collaboration with New Narratives as part of its West Africa Justice Reporting Project. I'm Anthony Stevens reporting.